class one performer. She has won the 4th Plum Blossom Award for Chinese Theater and the 1st Linghui Tu Award. She is a professor at the National Academy of Chinese Theater Arts in Beijing. Besides being a fine performer, Professor Tu also takes a step at directing. She is currently a visiting professor of Beijing Opera and Linghui Tu University. So please join me in welcoming Professor Tu.
First of all, thank you everybody for coming. Although we don't have many people here, but I believe that in the next hour, we'll enjoy together because I'm going to perform a lot for you.
那么，我今天的那个主题呢，是讲这个京剧的表演啊和赏析。
So my topic today is four character types and performing techniques.
然后中国的这个戏曲呢，它是有上千年的历史。
Chinese drama has a rich history of more than 1,000 years.
它一直到了这个近200年的时候，就是说京剧形成以后啊，它就基本上是集大家之长，成为一个非常非常优秀、具有代表性的剧种。
In the recent 200 years, Peking Opera has collected many performance techniques from different dramas and has formed its own system.
比如说，当时就很盛行的时候，就出现了四大名旦，就是这个左上角的四个名旦，他们均是男人演女人。So
there were four famous actors who performed in Beijing Opera. You can see in the upright corner, these four are all men, but they are all performing female characters.
有的演这种雍容华贵的女人，比如说梅兰芳。
For example, Maestro Mei Lanfang perform women who are elegant and come from rich family.
那陈燕秋呢，就演比较贫贱一点的女人，贫困一点的女人。陈燕秋
perform women from family that are not so well off.
然后尚小云呢，就是这边这边这个左边这个，她就是演比较这个活泼的，比较有一点武艺的，比较就是刚强的，助人为乐的这种女性，就是这个。On the
lower left, we see 尚小云. He performs these woman characters that are very energetic and sometimes involves with some martial arts.
然后这个呢，这个她就是演就是花旦，就性格比较。 开放，然后也是喜欢给人牵线搭桥、做姑娘这样的角色。And
on the lower right, we see Xu Huisheng, who performs those female characters who are very outgoing and like to introduce male to.
那梅兰芳呢，就是他的这个把京剧啊进行了一些改革。 就是，比如说他的服装，他的这个装饰都跟一千年前有所不同，比较追求一种美。梅兰芳
has reformed Jingju. He has done many changes to especially the clothings. These clothings look differently from what they were 1,000 years ago.
以前的这个演出的这个舞台呢，就是这个样子的，一般都是用真丝刺绣的这个台帘，然后看戏的人呢，可以是站着的，也可以是互相就是吃吃喝喝，这叫原来的表演的戏台，也有这种两层的，底下一层，上面一层，然后周围看戏。
So these pictures are the pictures of the stages in the early days. And in the left, we can see that's a curtain for the stage, background for the stage. Usually there is some Chinese embroideries on the curtain. And on the lower right, one, we see there are two stages. And people, when they are watching Peking Opera, they can sit, they can move around, they can talk, it's pretty free.
我给大家示范一段这个梅兰芳的贵妃醉酒吧，这个唱词在上面。
Professor is going to perform one of梅兰芳's famous, most famous drama, The Drunken Royal Concubine, and these are the lyrics. The musical instrument we use is called wu qing. It's a very Asian Chinese musical instrument.
而昆曲比京剧还要早两百年，所以它用的都是一些丝竹乐器，像笛子啊那些乐器。待会儿我会给大家演示。
Peking opera is very different from 昆曲, another kind of Chinese drama. 昆曲 actually appeared earlier than Peking opera, so the music instrument that 昆曲 use are also older. They usually use such as flutes, such kind of instruments, and I'm going to perform 昆曲 for you guys as well later on.
那个京剧里面呢，它的表演呢是比较程式化的，也就是说，它就四个字就概括了，就是各种人物的性格。你比如说生
There are four typical character types in 京剧 First one is called 生
蛋
Woman It means woman
这个是静意思啊就是很性格很夸张的那种他跟他都是慢但是呢他的性格就非常的豪放就不一样叫静
The third one is called jing Both sheng, the first one and the third one jing are male characters but the third one jing is more male is more exaggerated male character
主要这个是以性格啊来换的这个丑丑呢它就脸上有一个小有一点像我们的这个滑稽啊它不是那个丑陋的丑是 humor 是滑稽的意思这个是丑
The last one is called 丑 It's similar to a clown It doesn't mean that So 丑 in Chinese also means ugly But this character is not ugly Rather it's because he's very comic and like a clown
这个是生，就是生里面呢又有这个分年纪大的啊，年纪大的、年轻的啊，有武艺的啊，短板的，就是将和兵的这样，也就短板和长板。
So these four are all the different types of 生 the male characters. It can be divided according to age, old one or young one, or it can be divided according to how much martial art they know.So the third one is like a general who knows a lot, and the fourth one, the one on the lower right corner, is like a soldier, a small soldier.
这都是所有的声，还有娃娃声。你看小孩儿啊，小孩的娃娃声，整个精神。
We also have a type called 娃娃声，which is
children,
which means the little children, the little boys.
我给大家演唱一段声的演唱。老生的演唱，大家听一听老生的这个感觉是什么样的。
Professor Tu is going to perform the singing of an old sheng, old male character. 老生不用胡子，不要大胡子。
Oh! 要以性格划分的，我给大家试唱一下。这个就是昆曲的《牡丹亭》，可能大家比较熟悉。
Next one is that the female character, and the female characters can also be categorized according to their age or according to different criteria. And Professor Tu is going to perform 牡丹亭 from 昆曲，
就唱一半啊。
So she's going to sing a little bit.
时间的有一时间。
Yeah.
样的。现在是进，就是花脸。花脸的唱又不一样。花脸通常是就是演各种性格的人物，就是男性里面比较有刚正不阿的包公啊，有很多很多就是各种性格。
Now we are going to move on to talk about this jing, which means exaggerated male. This jing can have different kinds of personalities. For one type is that some jing can be very righteous, very care a lot for justice, such as Bao Gong, maybe the Chinese people know, who is a very righteous judge in the Chinese history.
Jing 的唱呢，我给大家唱一段，就是杂美案，就是他的故事。
教授，您怎么看待就是加入了这个西洋乐队的这个伴奏之后， 传统的乐伴奏之下，对你的这个表演有什么影响？
啊，是这样，加入这个西洋乐伴奏呢，应该是50-60年代以后，就是在中国。那么在中国这个50-60年代以前，通常都是叫传统的叫三大件儿。那么后来呢，也是由于这个中国在学习西方的一些文化，那么就把这个小提琴啊，或者是大杯子啊那些，加进了。因为在中国的音乐当中呢，它的低音部分不够，三大件你老听着前面，你们发现滋滋滋滋滋，总觉得很飘。如果加了一些贝斯啊，或者是加了一些大提琴啊，就会使得这个 声音比较平衡。但是我是这么认为的，艺术嘛，它应该是丰富的。比如说我们要去完全继承一个特别传统的东西，比如说是你就用三大件也可以。如果说有一些新唱的戏，如果加进一些西乐来，使得它这个音乐比较平均，那也未尝不可，我是这么认为的。
So the question is about what's professor's opinions on the new forms of performances where we have lots of Western influence, and professor's answer is that after 1950 or 1960, Chinese drama is more and more heavily influenced by the Western music culture. One of the problems of the Chinese music, traditional music, is that we have too much high pitch, so the music sounds kind of drifting away. Whereas the Western musical instruments such as cello or bass can add more low pitch sound into the Chinese traditional music, which will balance the whole performance. So her opinion is that she likes the diversity of different kinds of musical instruments in the Chinese traditional drama. And for the new style, new kinds of dramas, she encourages to have more Western, westernized musical elements.
My question is short. She didn't demonstrate the clown character, I don't think.
他说那个朱教授没有向大家展示那个丑角的唱功，大家想再多听一遍。
好的，那个丑角的唱功呢，它就会有一点滑稽。比如说这样哈，做人难就是这么一个。我就是干唱的，因为没有那个。
So Professor Tu is going to demonstrate the clown, but there's no background music shows.
正常的要是唱。做人难，要是丑呢，就是做人难，他就会加一些这个滑稽的音，他不是唱得很，就是像老师呢唱得很规范，他会又会有一点这样的感觉。
So the lyrics is life is so hard. So Professor Tu said it twice. The first one is what by the normal characters, and the second one is by the chou, the clown. And the two are quite bounce off sound.
如果你要是感兴趣的话呢，就点击京剧丑角的唱段，一下就出来了。里面有好多丑角的唱段，谢谢。因为时间的原因。
If you are want to see more.
All of the actors are still female, is that correct? For every role?
No,
no, no. 就是在以前是男女都有。以前是有四大名旦的时候是男的也女的。那么在近代就是男女角色都有。男女演员都存在。在稍微早一点的早期，就是不让女性出头露面的时候，那个时候是男的演所有的角色。
So now we have both female and male actors or actresses.
Not characters, but actual actors.
Actually, yes, we have male and female. So in the early times, like 1900, usually it was dominated by the male characters because female are forbidden to go out and perform on the stage for people.
So do males perform male roles and females perform female roles, or can a woman perform a male role and a man can perform, and apparently a man can perform a female role, is that right?
他的问题是，现在我们这个男性女性演员都有，那男性演员可以演女性的角色，女性演员可以演男性的角色。可以的，非常多。
So male actors can perform the male characters as well as female characters, and actresses can perform female characters as well as male characters. So it doesn't matter the gender. The gender doesn't matter.
而且现在很多年轻人都有女的老生，男的感觉，这样子的，在中国很出名。And
in the recent times, we see a lot of young female who will perform the old male character in the Beijing Opera, or like men who will perform the elegant female characters in the Beijing Opera.
You know, the one thing I noticed in her various performances here is that, at least to my ear, there was a very different tone of the voice. Like the female voice was very high, almost squeaky to my ear, and the male voices were deeper. Is that always true in Beijing opera, and is that true in Chinese society in general, where women are expected to speak in a more high-pitched voice, and males are kind of a lower-pitched, more almost gravelly voice?
男性女的时候身体比较低，但生活中男性女的时候都是高男生。Good，yes，就是女性嘛，本身生活当中我们女人说话都挺就高。那么在中国的戏曲，中国有很多个剧种，它基本上，但是有一点就是男性比较低，有老太太的那个是比较低的。
So Professor Tu said you made a very keen observation here. Yes, you're right. Female always have this, usually have this higher pitch than the male characters. There's only one exception, which is the old female character. So when it's old female character, the pitch is usually lower.
我给你唱一个old的，就是老旦的唱。
Professor Tu is going to perform for you from as a old female character.
它就是比较低的大嗓，it's
low pitch.
我说的意思呢，就是补充您说的，第一就是男的声音一般来说都比较低，但是小声是比较小嗓的。我请邀请您唱一段像周瑜或者是这样的，叫他开着眼，就是说中国的京剧呢，它是非常丰富的，不是那么简单化。
您会吗？周瑜，您唱一个。
我不是给您做难的，我就说两声，就是小声啊，一般的就像 love story， you can see a lot of male very handsome， you know very good figure， but it's a very high tone， but immediately you know it's a man， it's so it's Westerner probably think that the man is kind of homosexual， but it's not， it's man but a very high tone， extremely high tone， so。
Is that true in everyday Chinese life that we were talking to? 16 to 20 years young man,
usually going to be a scholar, and after that, love stories, so many. And the Xiaosheng professor has been doing well.
So around 200 ago,
我先说中文，然后你再说。就是说，这个西方的艺术，表演艺术，特别是这个摇滚乐和这个交响乐，它对中国的京剧的影响，这是冲击是不可估量的。特别是呢，自从改革开放以来呢，中国的年轻人，18岁、20岁，独生子的一代，很多人呢都崇拜于像 Michael Jackson 这样的这一潮流，特别是这 Internet 打开了。我很奇怪发现，通过 YouTube 呢，就是说京剧呢，这前10年这突然复生了，很多像这个张火丁这样的，还有这些老艺术家都还健在的话，突然带了很多的徒弟，造成了这种登峰造极。这种现象我不太容易理解，就是说这当然是好事，但是为什么中国经济它的生命力那么强？这是第一个问题。第二个问题呢，就是说美国人呢，像这在座的人，都特别不喜欢这个中国的经济特别慢。很多很多词也不懂了，就快睡着了，哎，拍电了，武打是行的。到后来，就是我的问题呢，就是说，对您来说，中国经济能不能世界化？能下一步就为了达到这种这个西方的交响乐和摇滚乐普遍全世界的这个中国经济本身。他是不是在内部变化？
Let me just speak in English. So my question probably, you as born in Western world in America, probably you will question. You never heard about this much about Peking Opera. The younger people in China did not hear that much about symphony orchestra or Michael Jackson rock and roll.But the last 20 years, a lot of Chinese, in mainland China especially, worship Michael Jackson, and some of them worship the symphony orchestra to much higher level. I was a little surprised through the YouTube, I see this suddenly in the last 10 years, Chinese Peking Opera rebirth, like Renaissance. A lot of new generation of Peking Opera singer, I never even know.For example, one called a female, her name called Zhang Huoding, is reached the level of astrophy to much, much higher level. So I asked the professor to explain why. The second question is that because of the Westerners, by far as I know, do not like the Peking Opera. It's too slow. It's not, I cannot quickly get a solution. And what is that? What's the end of it? How could Peking Opera evolve to popularize it to the level like symphony orchestra and rock and roll all over the world, rather than just understood or enjoyed by the Chinese themselves? So those are two questions from
我就简单回答吧，好吗？第一个就是任何的艺术它都会有，我们现在是一个全球化的这样一个世界啊，就肯定是各种艺术都会有交流啊，会有影响。但是呢，就是说本土的这种土生土长的这种京剧，因为它首先它是讲的是就是一个是政府的支持啊，极大的支持。因为我在中国戏曲学院，我就是做这个京剧进课堂的项目负责人。他们有大量的经费去推崇，从中小学一直到大学，因为这个是国粹艺术，它代表所有的群众。这是第二个，您刚才是说的世界化嘛？我是这么想的，就是一个本民族的艺术，它当然也是在改进。我刚才说是戏曲从1000年走到现在，就是说一直没有断，而不像印度的梵剧啊，好像是断掉了，或者是其他的。因为它一直在延续，那么它在延续的过程中，它就是肯定是双条腿走路，政府支持，民间也有喜好者。你比如说，现在中国是老龄化社会， 老年的那一代，他还是一直听戏过来的，所以他喜欢，然后慢慢的又影响下一代，下一代给他们一些，比如说展示的平台，可以去比赛啊，可以去拿奖啊，可以所以这样的话，尤其是我们中国戏剧学院作为唯一的高等院府嘛，应该是说在这方面得到政府的很大的支持。
So I think nowadays there are more and more influence between different kinds of forms of music or arts. I would like to make 2 points. I think in order to make Peking Opera survive, first we need to get more support from the government. I'm actually personally in charge of a project called Introducing Peking Opera to High School, Middle School, or even Primary School, to let more students get in touch with such kind of art. And the second point I want to make is that we also need support from people, not only from government. So many old people, they are still listening to Peking Opera, and their children, their offsprings, are influenced by them to listen to the Peking Opera as well. So we need to provide a stage for the young people to perform Peking Opera and to let them get access to Peking Opera.
至于说世界化，我觉得这个不要强求。各界各自有各自的爱好，这个属于一种自己喜欢就可以。
In terms of making Peking Opera to all of the world, to people all over the world, I think it's a personal choice. It's a taste of music depending on your own preferences.
那你们今天喜欢我的演唱吗？
Does everyone like my performance today?
Yeah, thank you. 我就是感谢孔子学院。我觉得交流非常重要，实际上任何一个艺术之间一拉近距离了，就觉得我们认识了，我们可以交流，我们可以互相愉悦。
I'm very grateful to Confucius Institute for giving this opportunity to perform a Peking Opera to you. I think cultural exchange is very important for us to know each other. It's not that we don't like each other's art, it's that we just like this opportunity to get to know each other.
下面呢，我给大家表演一下。刚才只是说了京剧的唱，实际上京剧它有四大支柱：唱、念、做、打。它行当里面生旦净丑。
So, before I just performed the singing skills to you. Actually, there were 4 different kinds of skill in Peking Opera. I'm going to perform another one.
那么我给大家演示一下念。念呢，它不像我们现在说的这个，比如说传统戏曲，它的念就要带音乐性。
I'm going to perform this stage speech skill to you. The traditional drama involves the speech involves more music. You speak more according to the rhythm of music.
它是由于那个我们古就是从古到今中国的文字。叫做都是可以唱的，比如说诗三百，孔子皆可弦歌之，中国的诗歌都是唱的，所以呢，我们在念的时候也要像唱一样，就是把诗歌念出来，实际上是把诗歌唱出来。
In Chinese history, actually all the poems can be seen instead of reading. So when we're performing the dramas, we are trying to sing all the lyrics rather than just talking, just speaking.
比如说我示范，我就是演示一段唐代中国的唐代的唐诗，完全就是可以唱。
I'm going to read you a poem from Tang Dynasty, but actually I'm going to sing it to you, not just read a poem.
那个这首唐诗很简单，就床前明月光，疑是地上霜。今天傍晚就能听
见。I just introduce a little background of this poem. So this poem is by a very very famous Chinese poet and the big picture of this poem is that this, he is missing his hometown a lot.
因为古人认为诗如果能够唱出来的话，就一定能够记住。唱也是便于记忆的一个非常好的方法。
Chinese people think that if a poem can be sung, then it's a very good way to assist you to memorize the poem. So making a poem singable is a way to assist memory.
这是一种吟唱，是逐歌的，不要音乐，没有音乐。
So such kind, so singing a poem does not require any background music.
好，
Okay.
she actually performs that, she should not be speaking. She's speaking just to explain what she's doing, but what she actually
performs. 那么舞蹈呢，就是很多拿的枪啊，今天就没有办法表演了。京剧的武功是非常高超的，它有很多的跟斗啊，就是翻的跟斗啊，和那个枪啊打得非常厉害。如果大家感兴趣，也可以报案。
This is a, so we also have martial arts in Peking Opera, and the martial arts in Peking Opera is pretty intensive. And today, usually there is gun or knives or 360
degree turn,
something like that, but here I cannot perform this for you. You can jump from the desk, jump from the mountain, you can fight with each other. There are different kinds of martial arts.
那个，然后呢，就是京剧啊，刚才大家说。 承接了一千年的艺术的集大成者，然后一直走到现在，然后走到现在，应该他也有一些这个吸纳现代人，也不是一直全部都是演这个头上戴的亮亮的，也是演现代人物，穿现代衣服。So
Peking Opera, although it has absorbed the essence of different dramas over the past 1,000 years. We also have contemporary Peking opera, where people wear more modern clothes instead of the traditional Chinese clothes.
然后我给大家看一个现代戏京剧。好，那个京剧的现代戏呢？
I'm going to show you the contemporary Peking opera.
就很生活，就是生活里的事情。
The story all comes from life.
竞选有最近有，以前呢都是派角色，就是大家觉得你很合适。现在呢就有，你比如说去年就是北方昆曲剧院要排这个《红楼梦》，就直接选了半个多月。
So nowadays we do have such kind of auditions to pick the actor or actress for a specific role. Before, in the old times, it's more like I designate someone to act some character. But now we have this audition. And a couple of...
就是去年吧。
Last year, when they are trying to put up a new Peking opera show, they have spent half a month trying to pick up
the appropriate characters. Because not just anybody can come on the screen and fly. So it's a certain amount of training. Yeah. Jingju is needed a lot of training. Yes, it is. How long has she
trained?
I'm 9 years old.
So Professor Tu started learning Peking opera when she was 9 years old.
And so how?
And 知道什么时候？您从九岁学到？
一般初科至少要七年，就是从小孩演到十七八岁这样的样子，可以演角色是六七年。
You need at least 6 to 7 years to graduate to be able to get on stage and perform for other people.
Seems like in Beijing Opera, stories, speech, costumes, movements, all traditional for Beijing Opera. Is there a food that is associated or traditional to Beijing Opera?
Food.
Can you have food? Mm-hmm.
他说，你刚刚介绍京剧的时候，说到有京剧传统的这个唱歌、念快，就是服装有特别的服装。
对，
他说有没有食物是京剧特别的食物？
就是带来的衣服，
不是吃的东西，有没有特别？
哦，
就你表演京剧必须要这个穿成那个，有没有什么特别的食物是跟京剧有关的？
没有，但是有这个茶，就是喝的水，比如说什么样的水比较嗓子比较清亮一些，可能会有，但是也不绝对，就是看个人。
So the short answer, there is no specific food that's associated with Peking opera, but there is some kind of special tea that's good for your voice, for you to perform Peking opera. But otherwise,
在那个传统的戏里面，还有演到一半的时候，有一人送茶过来，然后饮茶，饮完茶以后送回去，就这样。
In some shows, you will see while an actor or actress is performing, someone will come to the stage with a cup of tea for the actor or actress to.
My question also is common, maybe you can respond it, about the body movement or body language, artistic level, in such a high level, I was speaking Chinese, the finger movement, maybe you can expand it and illustrate for me and for everybody.How the female character described using the fingers. So, 我的问题呢，就是说中国京剧在这个无声语言，就是用身体和特别是手指来表达内心的这个感觉呢，已经到达非常高级，对世界各国的影响都非常大。请您能示范一下，特别是这个，您刚才表演的时候已经，我想专门的表演一下，让他们看一看，就是说这女的，比如说男的如何指，女的如何指，或者是这个女的如何表示她的羞怯和这个哭啊，男的如何，请您表演一下。
好，你比如说在这个行当里面啊，就这个手。如果要是旦角儿，就是女的，她就叫就叫这个掌就有各种掌手掌，这个叫兰花掌。你看这个看起来像一朵兰花带开的兰花。
For female characters, you have different hand gestures or hand movements. For example, this one is called Lan Hua Zhang or Orchid Palm because it looks like an orchid.
这个就是女的。 那要是老生呢，他就这样。For
all female,
非常有劲儿，把虎口张开，像一个荷叶一样。It's
more powerful, like a lotus leaf.
那要是花脸呢，他张牙舞爪，他就这样。Like
for
花脸是镜。镜。
For the exaggerated male,
他就这样。His
palm is like this.
小花脸呢可能会这样，稍微这个缩着点。
The next exaggerated male will have a gesture like a palm like that.
那要是旦角呢？要是指呢？是这么指的，比如说指这个，指出去。
When a female character wants to point at something, that's how she does it.
要是男的指，就是两个手指头指。
That's how the male character points at.
你看，这就显得有力量。要是花脸指出去，就不用关注，就这样。
That's how the exaggerated male character points at things.
然后呢，这是指的，然后这个手，掌和指，还有拳，女子的拳呢叫凤拳，你看，这样跟一个凤，一头一个凤一样。
That's the fist of a female character. It looks like a phoenix.
啊，叫凤。
The head of a phoenix.
那要是男子就是这样的。
Male will have fist.
拳头。那要是花脸的拳头就握住。
That's exactly male's fist.
好，就这样。 然后呢，这个手势呢有各种的表演。你比如说哈，说你和他两个人在一起有点意思，这就是表示两个人和好。
So that the whole process means
女人和男人两个人在一起。
A female and a male, they have chemistry between each other.
啊，这个。然后要是下雨，就是这样。
This is raining.
Raining. 哦，下雨了，然后小鸟叫，看，这样，
啊，远处啊，你看，远处有一只小鸟，That means see there is a bird singing, chirping.
Yeah, 雨，然后还有就是，比如说各种的，就是手腕的，你像这个手腕，它一个叫手腕花，这个。
This is the movement of the whole wrist, it's like a flower.
这实际上是一个像那个永远无止境的一个小太极的这种旋转.
It resembles the Tai Chi, like the small Tai Chi.
你看它永远是一正一阳，一反一阳，永远的旋转.
Which always has one, which has two opposite things revolving endlessly.
一会儿大家要喜欢，我可以教你。
I can teach you more afterwards.
然后他为了表示人的这个阳刚啊，就是中国的汉字“山”是这么样的写“山”，中国的汉字，这是一个中国的山。So monkey.
So the shape of this is it means mountain in China. That's the shape of the character. Means mountain.
他要表现人很大，像 monkey 一样，所以他会原来传统的时候是做这个。
If you want to demonstrate the male characters, you want to get that like a mountain.
对，后来变慢，就是美化了以后叫山膀，就平掉了，横平竖直，叫山膀。
In order to make it more, make it look nicer, you will lower your head.
就把这个山的就放下来，就变成山膀了。啊，那山膀完了以后呢？ 中国的这个手势呢，还可以把这个云，表现出来，像云手，就是手像一团云在胸前晃动。
That's called
云手山膀是中国最基本的动作，戏曲最基本的动作。The
cloud hand and this mountain.
啊，他把天上的这个 sky 天上的云和大山都用手势表现出来。
Combines the cloud and the mountain.
Yeah, this is the cloud. 转, 那云在转,
a revolving cloud.
然后有很多的动作都是模拟这个动物.
There are also many movements that mimics animals.
比如说鹞子翻身就是一个小鸟
For example, that means a bird flips over.
我给你们做一下腰子翻身。
A bird flips.
像 bird 翻。
Can I just, if you could demonstrate, thank you in the male and female. In the male, how do the elderly people express thank you? And in the female, older and younger, the female, how the yada and xiaojie, when you speak in Chinese, 能不能表演一下，比如说感谢或者谢谢，男爵、老生和小生，女爵、丫鬟和小姐，你能不能表演一下？
没问题，就是中国人喜欢这个谢谢是作，就是那个拱手啊。这个老生呢，通常是拳，然后掌。中国人讲究呢，就是，我的右手是经常会打人的，我把这个右手挡起来。非常感谢，我们和好。
That means thank you. So in Chinese culture, right hand is used more for fighting. So when I use my left hand to cover my right fist, that means I don't fight with you. Let's be friends. So that means thank you.
男，这是男的，谢谢。那要是女的呢，就表示我是比较谦卑一点，要下蹲，所以是谢谢。
That's how females say thank you.Because female wants to show that she is humble, so she crouches down a little bit and then.
当然，我们也可以这样，谢谢。
That's also another way for female to say thank you.
但现在被日本学习了，要更多。
But Japanese people have taken that away from us, so we use the other one.
还有看生蛋的谢谢，还有你刚才还有。
我是那个迷你的表情丫鬟。和小姐这两个表示感谢不一样
啊，对，那要是小姐呢，那就要用水袖了。小姐呢是这样，比较文静，就一下低头谢谢。丫鬟呢啊，谢谢啦，她就会这样表示比较活泼。Thank you.
So, the first thank you, the one which is more elegant is the thank you from these ladies from
小姐比较稳重
well educated families.The second one, which is more joyful one, comes from the servants of the ladies.
May I just add one thing? Because the professor here dressed up, you can see that's not long sleeve. It's very unfortunately, most Americans do not understand the sleeve is extremely long. Supposedly, because Confucius said that you never, like, people see your finger except your husband. And plus, there's a lot of beauty in there. And so,Maybe you can explain by...
它是长水袖是吧
right, yes.
说很可惜您就是没有能看到今天您能够展示一下水袖的这个因为它的水袖特别的特别
那我有一个课件看能不能再放出来一下
Yeah, when she tried to learn, because this is the part of most Americans do not understand is the long sleeve is expressed such a poetic way, but if you have to be Chinese, then you kind of appreciate. And that's the difficult part of people.
我一般水袖可以很长很长，两丈多都可以上。
Yeah.
那就是在中国戏曲，它就是因为有很多技巧啊，有很多技术，我不知道我这里面有很多技术性的东西，就是表演，就是加大它的这个表演难度。比如说水袖很长，比如说枪很要扔起来，要踢，要翻，要很多。
So the longer the water sleeves, the more difficult it is for people to perform. So that adds difficulty to performance. Other things such as if you want to toss a gun, very heavy gun, to perform this martial art, it also adds difficulty. So Professor Tu is looking for some.Slides where maybe you can see the long sleeves.
Oh,
this is the part of the thing.
Actually, I personally have performed many dramas, many painting opera with the long sleeves, but I cannot open the file here. But if you go online and Google my name, you will see the picture of me wearing these long sleeves and performing with these long sleeves.
One of the, I want to mention, everybody can go to YouTube, 天女散花, and the sleeve is much, much longer than you can imagine. But somehow it's described in the early spring, thousands of flowers come out, and then this goddess of flower, and then expressed by this dance, but using the long sleeves. And you probably never even see a finger, but you imagine that flower all over the world because of the goddess of flower, you know.
Lecture, and thank you for coming.